Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today is day 13 of Scraptember 22. It is also Stash Dive Tuesday and I will be using my How to Kill a Kit with Style September kit. And I am going to be scrapbooking 16 pictures of the Nighttime Spectacular at the castle at Walt Disney World. This was in December, and these are projections that are on the castle and the fireworks. So if you have never been to this fireworks display, it is absolutely beautiful. So I am just kind of looking at the orientation of my photos because I'm going to make a Project Life page because I have so many photos and I really do want to use all of them. I'm going to go ahead and make a Project Life card or Project Life scrapbook. So what I'm doing is looking for my papers that I want to use out of my kit. All of this is from Ellie Studio. I have a huge collection. There's actually, I believe, a video on my channel of me organizing all of my Ellie Studio. And so I am glad to be using up some of this. So because my photos are not true 4x6, I did cut out 4x6 cardstock to put behind them. My photos I got from Amazon photo processing, and so they're not a true 4x6, which initially I didn't think I would mind, but when I'm doing Project Life, I kind of mind. So I'm kind of laying them out to decide where I want them. I'm not actually going to keep all of these landscape photos on the front because I am going to do a third page. So what I'm going to do, and actually that photo there that's totally rainbow, that was the inspiration for what I decided to do. I decided I was going to make kind of a rainbow Project Life card. And so I'm just cutting down my vertical portrait photos, I cannot talk today, into 3x4 so that they will go down the middle of my page protector. And I'm just going to go ahead and cut those out. I'm not going to make you watch me cut all of them because there are a lot of them, but I'm just kind of showing you kind of my cropping technique. I'm kind of deciding where I want to make those cuts. Some of the tops of my castle get cut off, but I don't mind actually because there are so many pictures of the castle that I really wanted to get what was important. And because there are projections onto the castle, I wanted to make sure that that was what was happening. So once I have those done, I'm going to lay them out kind of in what I think is close to rainbow fashion. So I kind of have that pink one, there's some orangish yellow, there's some green, blue, purple. So I'm just going to kind of put those in order. And then as you can see, there's a lot of blue and purple. And so that's actually going to be the third page that I'm going to do. But I thought that I would go ahead and get that done and get them in the page protectors. So I'm just kind of laying them out in the direction that I think I would like for them to go. And because I'm kind of doing a two-page spread, the left side is actually the back side of the page protector. So I have to turn it around and put it in there. So I'm just going to quickly put the photos in there. I'm going to speed up the video just a little bit so that you can see kind of what my process is, but it took a really long time. And so I didn't want to make the video too long. So as you can see, I'm kind of putting the red, the yellow, the orange, the green, kind of in rainbow order and deciding where I want things to go. I will shuffle them a little bit because I did find some pink and I found some black and rainbow that I'm going to put towards the end. So I am going to shuffle these around just a little bit. I found some scraps of my 6x8 paper that I thought would go well. So I am going to kind of move those around. But it was honestly kind of a fun process to look for my Project Life cards. I actually, and if you watch that video, and maybe I'll tag it in this video so you can see, when I was sorting my Project Life cards from LE Studio, I actually did put them in order by color. So it was pretty easy for me to find the colors that I needed because they were already filed in order. So I'm going to put that pink and red and yellow and orange, and I kind of have that random star up there, but I think it works. I didn't really have two orange ones, so I think it works fine. So now that I have those out, I'm going to start embellishing my cards, and I did skip a little bit because I'm basically going to do tone-on-tone embellishing. So I have a whole bunch of different embellishments in my stash. Most of them are from my How to Kill a Kit with Style kit for September, and so I'm just going to pull a few of those things. I have those puffy words, which I think is wonderful because I love that I was able to use that happiest place, because certainly this is the happiest place on earth, and this was definitely a happy time. We were there celebrating my birthday, and it was great to watch the fireworks. This was the first time we had been back where the fireworks show was actually going, so it was great. We'd gone a couple of other times, but because of COVID, they had shut down a lot of the activities, and so even though the parades weren't back, the fireworks were back, and so that was really kind of an encouraging feeling, I guess, when you started to get back to a little sense of normalcy. So that was nice. So I'm just going to continue on embellishing these and trying to figure out what I want to go where. I did do some different shades of colors on tone on tone. So there's still like that green one is still like a mint green, but then there's kind of a more lime green. And I think it works. At any rate, I like it. And so I guess that's what counts. I really do like to do these Project Life layouts every once in a while. I don't have a ton of them. I don't do them every month. That's not typically how I scrapbook, but when I have a lot of photos and I know I'm going to have some coordinating pages, it's nice because I don't really want to sacrifice the pictures. I know that I want to keep those pictures, and I know that I want to display them in some way. And so rather than just putting them in the pockets, it feels nice to be able to kind of be creative with it. Even though, honestly, this particular layout, because I'm doing such a heavy embellishment, it's not really a time saver. So once I've finished the two front pages, I'm going to do the back of the right side. I'm not going to do the back of the left side just yet. Because I have some other photos and I'm not sure how I want to put them in my album yet. So as I continue to work on the back, I'm just slipping those in and I like the way the colors are. I'm still trying to keep them sort of in a rainbow order, even though most of it is kind of blue and purple. I did put that green, kind of lighter blue over to the left. And on this side, rather than using Project Life cards, I am going to use these awesome vellum embellishments. And I've used them in one other layout and really, really love them. I did mention in my other layout that I didn't see the adhesive. I need to clarify that because when I put one on black cardstock, I could absolutely see the adhesive that I was using. I cannot see it when I put it on white cardstock. So as you can see up there, I was like, oh no. So I ended up covering that up with some word phrase stickers, and I think it worked out just fine. But you can definitely see if you're using like a tape runner or something like that. Now I could use some glue. I have some Nuvo glue that dries clear, and that would have been fine to use, but the damage was already done, and so when in doubt, cover it up, right? So that's what I did, and I'm just going to add a few more little touches here, add in some vellum and some of my puffy stars that I have been using throughout this particular series. And that's going to be about it. Now, the final touch that I'm going to do, there are some large vellum words that I had gotten, and one says fireworks and one says castle. And so I am going to tuck those in. I'm actually not even going to adhere them down. I like how they look kind of loose. It kind of makes a little shaker-ish. And so there is the front, and I'm counting them. I have 16 photos that I ended up using, and here are the close-ups, the front, the back, and all the little details. My title, Nighttime Spectacular 2022. I kind of use that to make a little Mickey head. And yeah, so thanks again for stopping by my channel. I appreciate you so much. I would love it if you like this video, if you give me a thumbs up. If you are a subscriber and you've returned, thanks so much. If you've not yet subscribed to my channel, consider maybe hitting that subscribe button. I have a lot of fun things coming up, and I hope that you will join me. Have a magical day, everyone, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.